Hello YouTube, and welcome back one and all to part 26 of our 30 band Royal Rumble. We are down to the very nitty gritty stuff, ladies. Sorry guys, I just felt like my part of my soul just died there, because listen to me guys, my room's a mess. It's just gone midday on Sunday, half the day is over. We're nearly halfway into July. I am so absolutely incandescently out of energy, out of motivation, out of hope, out of just about everything that most people need to continue to doing this stuff. I am absolutely running on fumes at this moment. So you know what? Let's fuel it with something else. We need that. Let's get some fuel in, boys. Let's do it. My burps are getting louder and longer every single day from now on. So anyway, what was my point? Oh yeah. Let's put on a happy face. So you know what? Oh, who the fuck am I kidding? How about we just get started and with number 26, maybe that will cheer us up. So, if you guys want to check out the original video for yourselves, links will all be in the description down below. Let's begin. Let's get started with entry number 26. So, let's greet them in 10, 9, 8, 7, 6, 5, 4, 3, 2, 1, and activate.
I will give you the stars in the sky, but they're too far away. If you are a hooker, you know I'd be happy to pay. If suddenly you were a guy, I'd be suddenly gay. 'Cause my heart belongs to you. My love is pure and true. My heart belongs to you. But my cock is community property. You're the only girl that I like to screw when I'm not on the When I come home, my dinner's made, and the front lawn is mowed. I'll kiss your mouth, even after you swallow my love. 'Cause my heart belongs to you. There ain't nothing that I wouldn't do for you. It's community property. It hurts from my head to my feet. I think of you when I can't help but fondle my meat. I see your face every time that I go out and cheat. Cause my heart belongs to you.
You know, it's nothing out of the ordinary for this this marathon that we would go from. How exactly did we go from a song about Eugene Shoemaker to a song about that is essentially more or less a parody of Bed of Roses by Bon Jovi? It's, you know, maybe that's what we should call Steel Panther from now on. It's like Broken Bon Jovi. They're exactly like the normal Bon Jovi. But with all the Jovi taken out. Oh, that one was not nearly as good as the first one. I apologise for that. So anyway, ladies and gentlemen, that was Community Property. It's, yeah, you know, it's strange, again, because how exactly, where do you even begin with a song like that? That is basically about, I mean, when you get, you know what, when you think about captivating lines like, when I'm not on the road, when I come home, my dinner's made, and the front lawn is mowed. I'll kiss your mouth even after you swallowed my load. Like, what on earth do you say to something like that? Apart from, I mean, yeah. I mean, guys, listen. I mean nothing of it, but I generally do like it after a long day of work. I get home and, you know what, there's at least some, I don't care if there's anything on the table, just as long as there's something in the house that's edible and that has not been eaten yet. I will friggin' chow down on it. You know, I don't particularly think that's a very, a tough thing to say or a tough thing to do, because just, yeah. But what I, and so, the first concert I ever went to back in February, being Steel Panther, and I think they friggin' said that that Nicky was like the very first person to, you know, beat COVID-19. God almighty, I straight up hope that's true, because to be honest, I'm pretty sure, you know what, if COVID-19 was a woman, ladies and gentlemen, not even Steel Panther would go near it. You'd avoid that shit like the plague, like Miss Two-Ton Tina or Stephanie McMahon. You just don't want to go anywhere near them. Oh dear. Oh dear. So, yeah, okay, I'll tell you what. If there's one thing I want to say is that, you know what? Had I more the time in the world to listen to Steel Panther, I probably would. Because you know what? I feel as if, like, you know what? At least they try to, you know, be funny. And, you know, at least they're trying to make me feel better. And you know what? I reckon, you know what? If I was in a slightly better mood, and if I was even more... Actually, you know what? I think that's the big problem. It's not that I'm not in the right mood or mindset for this. It's because, straight up, I'm not drunk enough yet. So, you know what? There's about, like, half a bottle left. Okay, ready? I got an idea. Ready? It's time for... I'm still not happy. Nah, you know what? I you know, my cock is community property. You know what? You know, when that concert was over, Death to All But Metal, why the bloody hell did I not just get on that bus and tour with these guys? Why the hell did I not just, you know, sing songs about girls from Oklahoma or screw 12 fat chicks? Why was I not partying with these guys? Why don't I not wear, like, fishnets for arms with all holes in, like Jeff Hardy? Why did I not get... grow my hair out to be anything like these guys? Like, what the hell was I thinking? What the hell was I thinking? And what the hell am I doing? So... because I can guarantee to every single one of you, ladies and gentlemen, that night was the freaking last shred of happiness I must have had before COVID. And you know what? At least we had some fun. Well, at least I had some fun anyway. Oh, God. I want to be community property. I want to be... you know, step forward and, yeah, have my dinner on the table. Oh, God, I'll see you guys again next time. Have my dinner on the table. Yes, please.